Heat wave 95 has engulfed the state of Florida. You just saw what happened in Fort Lauderdale. On tonight's program, a battle royal. The winner gets a shot at the Sandman and the World Heavyweight Championship. It's the Tampa Bay Brawl. The heavyweight champion of the world will be overseeing the Tampa Bay Brawl, a battle royal to determine who will receive the title shot at his heavyweight championship belt. Again, the winner of the Tampa Bay Brawl immediately following the end of the battle royal will go one-on-one with Batman, the Sandman, steeped in his training regimen. They're doing some 12-ounce curls. That contest will take place at the end of the Tampa Bay Brawl.
Raven all over Ian Rutten. Scorpio being choked in the corner by Pitbull 2. Up and over goes Pitbull 1. Pitbull 1 has been eliminated, as has the Vampire Warrior. Dudley Dudley punishing Mikey Whipwreck. Dudley Dudley gets Pitbull 2. Finally, Richards enters the contest courtesy of Dreamer. Richards exits the contest courtesy of Dreamer. Here comes Raven. Dreamer's eliminated.
Tommy Dreamer has been eliminated.
And Mikey gets Raven. We're down to just five. Whip Foreman. And run. Two code Scorpio. A powerbomb. Mikey Whipwreck. And Mikey gets caught in the face with a kick. Ian Rotten squared off with Marty Jannetty. But Mikey's in big trouble. Standing drop kick. Rotten hits the floor. We're down to three. And it doesn't look good for Mikey. Frank and Mikey. Scorpio's eliminated. It's Marty Jannetty and Mikey Whipwreck.
Where the hell is the bartender at when you need him?
Just disregard anything he says for right now. Mikey Whipwreck and Marty Jannetty. Whipwreck looks exhausted. And maybe still favoring that injured shoulder. Sandman, since winning the World Heavyweight title, has become a vicious animal. Mikey whipped in hard. Mikey whipped in again. Flying head scissors out of nowhere. Mikey takes over on Marty Jannetty. Mikey Mikey showing signs of fatigue and pain. Danny ducks his head, and Mikey with the spinning knee. Throw behind by Jannetty. Mikey holds up. Super kick. And that will be all for Mikey. No! Mikey wins it! Mikey wins it! Mikey wins the Tampa Bay Brawl and the title tie!
And now, ladies and gentlemen, Mikey Whipwreck will get a shot at the ECW World Heavyweight title.
Jannetty, none too happy. Beaten, plain and simple. There's a handshake. There's a display of sportsmanship. Here comes the Sandman. He came, Jannetty. He doesn't have to wrestle Jannetty. He did that for sheer enjoyment. Jannetty is hot. He wants the Sandman. The referee's restraining Marty Jannetty. Jannetty's furious. And the Sandman still has his back turned to Mikey. I think it's safe to assume that as far as this title match goes, Mikey now has one more fan in Marty Jannetty. Referees Jim Molino and Frankie Reyes escorting Marty Jannetty back to the locker room. The only official left to call this match, unfortunately, is referee Bill Alfonso. The Sandman hands over the cane to Alfonso. Guess he figures he won't need it. What the hell, he's already used it. Sandman just slapping Mikey. And just dumps Mikey over the top rope. Mikey must be exhausted from winning the Battle Royal. The Sandman drops the guillotine. The Sandman just insulting Mikey. Self-induced rage. If he hits this pile driver, this world title matchup is history. There it is. Cover. One, two, and that's it. An exhausted Mikey Whipwreck may have stood a chance, but in the condition he was in, not to mention the king shot to the back of his head before the matchup.
You think you could get extreme enough to take this from me? Look at my body. You ain't extreme. We'll be right back.
coming to you from the Expo Park in Tampa, Florida, on tonight's program, a rematch for the ECW television title Eddie Guerrero defends once again against the Shooter Dean Malenko. Also on tonight's program, we'll have comments from Taz and the Steiner Brothers with an update on the condition of Taz's neck. And folks, here's a surprise, an impromptu visit from Mikey Whipwreck. Mikey, you've got nothing to be ashamed of. You won the Tampa Bay Brawl. The Sandman slugged you with the cane before the matchup. I think you could have taken him.
Sandman, ever since you won the World Heavyweight Championship, you've been a monster. And I've been a former television champion and a former tag team champion with Cactus Jack. And, well, I'm going to challenge you to a Singapore caning match, Sandman. And if I can't pin you, I'll take 10 lashes with the Singapore cane.
Oh, my God.
Because I'm going to prove to you that I can be just as big a scumbag as you are.
You're a nice guy. What are you doing? Those things are horrible for you, Mikey. You're a nice guy. And what? Give me that.
Well, you heard the challenge from Mikey Whipwreck, who won the Tampa Bay Brawl and was jumped by the World Heavyweight Champion before the match started. He just issued the challenge for a Singapore caning match. If he can't beat the Sandman, he'll take 10 lashes from the Singapore cane. Well, the Sandman has accepted Mikey's challenge, and besides the rematch for the television title with Guerrero defending against Malenko, it will be the Sandman in a rematch for the World Heavyweight title versus Mikey Whipwreck. It will be a Singapore caning match. The loser of the matchup will receive 10 blows from the Singapore cane. And I pray the loser of that matchup, for many reasons, is the Sandman. Last week we saw the injury occur to Taz. Taz went down with an injured neck. We go now to comments from Taz and his new six-man tag team partners, Rick and Scott, the Steiner Brothers.
The Steiner Brothers have not wrestled in the United States in over a year and a half. And the only reason we're coming to ECW, because ECW lets you be as wild and crazy as you want to be. So Malenko, Chris Benoit, Scorpio, we're going to kick your ass. Boys, come down to the dog pound and find out what it's going to be like. You see, it's not personal, it's just business. Come on down, boys, we'll make you famous. I'll do my talking in the ring.
I got the bomb on it, I let it fly. I came out the sky and I got the bomb on it. You know what I'm saying? Cause I'm on like neck bones. You know what I'm saying? Hey, I think it's time to get ready for showtime. Damn, another day, another dollar. Damn, this locker room reminds me of some of my project days. Well, I can remember when I was in the projects, the way we just come up and just drop the bomb on you. You know what I'm saying, Taz? Let me tell you something. Just a minute. See these boots here? You know, another day, another dollar, because it's showtime. But every time I lace these boots up, it's time for somebody out there to take an ass kicking. Because when I fall off the sky and I come off the top rope and I drop the bomb on Yo Heine, somebody got to go down for the three. Taz, I know you're scared. You sitting there, you ain't got a whole lot to say. But let me tell you something. I know you ran off and you call yourself getting the Steiner Brothers. Steiner's this, Steiner that. Well, let me tell you something. Steiner Brothers, y'all can kiss my ass too. You know what I'm saying? Because this is the ECW, baby, and we're taking it to the extreme. You want to talk about business? Well, let's talk about business. Business is me coming down there, dropping a bomb on you. It's like Chris Benoit, the crippler, putting you out. You know what I'm saying? And then you got the shooter himself, Dean Malenko. Look at that. You know, they used to talk about the triple threat. Psst, Shane Douglas, he couldn't keep up with this. That's why they replaced him with Two Cold Scorpio. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm one of the greatest. That's right, goddammit. I'm one of the greatest high flyers of all time. I float like a butterfly, I sting like a bee. When I put these boots on, I'm a worm out of your booty. You know what I'm saying out there? So let me tell you this. I'm ready to put my boots on. I'm ready to get mad. I'm ready to step to the ring and I'm ready to kick some ass. You know what I'm saying? Because it's showtime and it's on like a hot pot of steaming neck bones. Because when I get in that ring, whether it be the Steiners or whether it be Taz or whether it be
Eddie Guerrero. It don't matter. Somebody's gonna have to take the bomb. And when I drop the bomb on you, baby, you know what time it is. You're going down for three. One, two, three. And when it's all over, said and done, whoop, there it is. And I'm gone. See ya.
This matchup is for the ECW television title. It's a continuation of the most scientifically heated classic wrestling feud going on today. Champion Eddie Guerrero defending against that man, the shooter Dean Malenko. And word out of the Malenko camp this week was that if Malenko could not regain the title here in his hometown of Tampa, Florida, he would no longer petition for any further title matches. Guerrero takes Malenko down with the hammerlock. Guerrero trying to turn Malenko over on his shoulders. Does two count only. Guerrero tying up Malenko's arm. Shooter escapes.
Pick the face up.
Take it in the air. Malenko with the arm of Guerrero this time. Guerrero with the reversal. Malenko not to be outdone. They exchange hammerlocks. Single-leg sweep by Malenko, won by Guerrero. If you want to see wrestling, you're watching the right promotion. And as we have seen in the past, these two may be the most evenly matched opponents competing in the sport today. Of strength coming up. I'm tempted to give the strength advantage to Malenko, but as you can see, leverage is already playing a part in this contest. Nice bridge by Guerrero. By Malenko as well. Nice monkey flip. Guerrero lands on his feet. And the fans here in Tampa are very appreciative of the athletic prowess of both competitors. You're looking at it right now. Malenko shot in. Guerrero ducks down from goes Malenko, and Malenko dropped by Guerrero. Scoop and a slam. Slingshot, somersault, splash. Cover, one, two, two count only. Pulling back on the arm from Malenko, the knee placed firmly between the shoulder blades of the shooter. Now using the head for leverage. Malenko fighting off the pain. Will not submit. Standing on the back of Guerrero's knee, reverses the hold. Well-placed elbow by Guerrero. There's an uppercut. Chop. Malenko set in. Tip up in the corner. Reversal on the waistline. Once again by Malenko. Malenko hits the turnbuckle. Flying head scissors of sorts by Guerrero. Malenko shot in. Up and over. There's a flying head scissors from the shooter. Malenko with the kip up, drops down, up and over goes Guerrero off the ropes. Drop kick in midair by Guerrero. Malenko and Guerrero putting on a wrestling clinic. Guerrero drop kicks Malenko in the knee. Oddly enough, tore that page out of the shooter's book. And Guerrero with the submission hold on the shooter. Referee Frankie Reyes asking Malenko if he wants to give it up. Malenko with no answer, that's a negative. STF by Guerrero. Guerrero pulling back on the head of Malenko. But Malenko will not give it up. Reaches the bottom rope, Guerrero breaks the hold. But does not let up on the challenger. Reversal on the Irish whip. Well placed knee by Malenko. Stretch. shot in. Rolls up Malenko out of nowhere. Two count only. Arm ringer into a pump handle. Into a backbreaker. Cover. Two and no. A sign. Guerrero trying to stretch out the spine of Malenko. Did I say trying? Guerrero stretching out the spine of Malenko. Malenko escapes, rolls up Guerrero.
Has one of his own. Malenko
makes the top turnbuckle. Guerrero ascends to the top. Drop kick to the back of the neck. Guerrero says that's all. German suplex. There's a bridge. Two count only. Fisherman suplex. Two and up. Championship Wrestling television title. What a fantastic matchup from both wrestlers. Great sportsmanship on the part of Eddie Guerrero. Another handshake. That's where the short arm clothesline. Well, I guess we haven't seen the last of this feud. These two will clash again for that title. You can bet on it.
He wanted the rematch he's got. That belt is on the line. And Mikey's not wasting any time.
Mikey goes crashing to the canvas. Woman looks on as the Sandman stomps the challenger. And what a great champion Mikey would make. Now there's a role model for all the kids. Talk about a miracle story. Spinning kick nicely done. Ducks for his life. But the Sandman catches Mikey coming off the second turnbuckle. Mikey clutching his gut. Probably still exhausted from the Tampa Bay Brawl. Double axe handle on the champion. Snapmare takeover. Leg drop. Picture perfect standing drop kick. Cover. One count on. Sandman smiling, taking Mikey very lightly. He explodes out of nowhere. Mikey hits the pile driver. The Sandman is out. Mikey's going to be the new heavyweight champion of the world. Mikey's going to the top. He's going to finish off the Sandman.
He slipped! Mikey slipped! The Sandman falls on top of Bombard! Of all the dumb luck! Mikey had the match won! According to the stipulations that both men agreed to.
Due to the stipulation to this match, oh my God. Mikey Whipwreck must receive 10 lashes with the Singapore cane.
Well said by ring announcer Ron Lemieux. Oh my God, has never rung truer. Woman wants to stay in the ring to watch this.
Hey, Mikey!
Oh, it's 10 of them, Mikey. We've been here before.
Assume the position, little boy. There you go. Yes! Yes! Oh, yes! No! No!
He doesn't have... Sandman, Mikey doesn't have to do this. I'll take him.
Referee Jim Molino volunteering to take the shots for Mikey.
To do this.
Money, you don't have enough clout, and you certainly don't have enough fans behind you. It's not you I want to get caned. It's not you at all. It's him.
Oh!
Yes! Oh, yes. I just love the violence. Can you feel it in the air? What? What is wrong?
I'd love to see Jim Decker.
A woman like myself, you have to show me how much you can take. Come on, Mikey.
Oh, you're old enough to be his
show
mother.
Show me how
Shut
much
up.
You can take. What?
Leave him alone. Leave the kid alone. Really, leave him alone, please. I'll take him. Leave
now,
him
ring announcer Ron Lemieux wants to make the sacrifice for Mikey Whipwreck. I think everyone in this building understands that Mikey is not physically capable of absorbing this type of punishment. If this continues, Mikey may be permanently injured.
No. See, you're just an announcer. You're just a measly little announcer. You haven't got enough money. Nothing but a Florida wannabe. You're not the one I want to see get caned. It's him.
Oh.
Yes. Oh, yes, Mikey. Yes, Mikey, yes. Oh, yes. Mikey.
Ron, is Jim on Flutter? You do it. If anyone knows of a woman more evil than this one somewhere on this planet, throw her in a big burlap sack with some boulders and throw her in the river, please. Boy, do I have compassion for Kevin Sullivan right now.
Oh! Little boy. Impress me, Mikey. Show me what you're really made of, little boy.
Number six coming up. Can't we stop this? The point's been made. Oh, my God. Promoter's license has already been suspended in the state of Pennsylvania as well as in the state of Florida.
No, Commissioner, I want more.
His position as commissioner is in jeopardy right now, but somebody with authority had to put a stop to this. What's he doing out here?
Todd Gordon, I want you to listen to me real. You want to take him back? You want to take him back? That's fraud. That's
fraud.
False advertising.
False advertising.
Stipulation said it has to be 10. It doesn't say it could be more. It doesn't say it could be more than 10. Sandman, get him.
What? You son of a... What do you mean, get him? Oh, my God! Bill Alfonso is gone for sure. Somebody stop him! That's 10, now knock it off!
Never. Yes.
Wait a minute. You're finished.
Yes, Simon, yes.
Marty Jannetty came out. He's covering Mikey and taking the brunt of those blows with the Singapore King.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is your post-game wrap-up. As we saw earlier tonight, Mikey Whipwreck received a hellacious beating at the hands of the Sandman and the Singapore Kane. Unfortunately, that incident will be part of a highlight package from both Fort Lauderdale and Tampa entitled The Sunshine State Slaughter, available now if you call 1-800-357-8393. Mikey Whipwreck showed extreme bravery challenging the Sandman to a Singapore caning match after losing to him earlier this evening. Mikey lost the matchup, took 10 lashes. Bill Alfonso said it had to be 10. We haven't heard the last from Mikey Whipwreck.
You know something, Sandman? I want you to come up here real close because I think you're kind of retarded and you're here with your eyes. And I want you to see what I'm saying. I used to have a lot of respect for you. I thought you were the epitome of ECW. The man goes to the ring smoking a cigarette, drinking a beer with the finest woman in wrestling, and then gets in there and kicks ass. That's pretty extreme to me. But what you did to this kid right here, that wasn't extreme. That was stupid. And I've lost all respect for you. And I got a whole different opinion of you now. To me, you're nothing but a beer drinking, some cigarette smoking, fat beer belly pig. And I tell you what, my man, I've been in a lot of fights. I've had my ass kicked. And I'm sure down the road I'm gonna get my ass kicked some more. There's one thing that anybody can count on that knows me. I will not back down from any fight. And what you've done to this kid and what you've done to me, well, you've opened a whole new can of whoop-ass. Because you're going to see a side of Marty Jannetty that ain't nobody ever seen. You want to see extreme, my man? You're fixing to see extreme. You're going to see me like you don't ever want to see me. I'm going to come after you, my man, and I'm going to kick your ass. And, my man, I want to tell you one thing. For what you did out there, to stand there and take that from the Sandman, you're the bravest kid I've ever met. Your time's coming.
My mom is going to kill me. I've seen Sabu forget what fans made him a star. I've seen Shane Douglas wuss out. I've seen Bill Alfonso come in and ruin what ECW is all about for everyone. I've seen Taz get hurt. Taz. And I know I could get really hurt. So Sandman, it's time for Mikey Whipwreck to take you to the extreme.